उबंटू मेडिंग एक्स एंड मेडिंग है पर पर नॉलेज रिप्रेजेंटेशन ओके कंटिन्यू था लास्ट लास्ट पे फॉरवर्ड देखिए फॉरवर्ड है ना बैकवर्ड देखिए बैकवर्ड नेक्स्ट का नहीं उठी लो एग्जांपल का इनिशिएटिंग इंस्टेंस फिर कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग एग्जाम रिप्रेजेंट एज ए कैजुअल फॉर्म इज ए बैच लिविंग थी इंक्लूड एग्जाम इज ए एक्स कॉमा लिविंग थी दैट इज ए एक्स कॉमा एनिमेस इज अ लक्षकमा एनिमेस इज अ लक्षकमा ह्यूमन इज ए लक्ष का मत ह्यूमन इज इज ए लक्ष का मैन फाइनल इज ए जॉन का मैन जॉन इज ए मैन इज एग्जाम्पल Here the corresponding action semantic network representation is shown. Here this is an example of illustrating inference methods Here, okay, direction. Last class discussed about direction in extended semantic network. Here also inference rules. Here, okay, inference rules. Okay, what is the inference rules? Inference rules are embedded in the representation itself. Embedded representation itself. Since of the inference rules are being discussed as follows. One, first point, the representation of the inference for every action of giving. There is an action of taking in casual logic is action of f of x take, that is action of x comma give. Okay. The implementation of this rule is that the event of taking action is a function of the event of giving action. Giving action. Here in the external semantic net representation, functional terms such as f of x are represented by a single node. F of x are represented by single node. Okay. The representation of the statement action of f of x comma take, that is action of x comma give, is external semantic net. That is so. External semantic net representation f of x action take f of x next x that is action give. Here the representation of the inference for every action of giving, there is an action of taking in casual logic is action of f of x take, that is the action of x comma give. Okay. Here the implementation of this rule is that the event of taking action is a function of the event of giving action. Here in the external semantic net representation, functional terms such as f of x are represented by a single node. Okay. Here represented by single node. The representation of the statement action of f of x take, action of f of x take, that is action of x comma give. Okay, this is the extended semantic network representation. Clear? Action of f of x take, action of f of x take, that is the action of x comma give. The second inference rule here, the inference rule that an actor who performs a taking action is also the recipient of this action and can be easily represented in causal logic. Here External semantic in ad as given below. Recipient.
This is recipient. This is actor. This is action. You too. Action.
Action. Take. This is the action semantic net.
Yes, action semantic network representation. Okay.
Here the inference rule that an actor who performs a taking action is also the recipient of this action. And can be easily represented in causal logic. Okay, here external semantic net as given below. Okay, here E is a variable representing an event of an action of taking. Okay, event of action of taking. Here recipient of E comma S. That is action of E comma T, action of E comma F. Okay, E comma F, E comma T. Here recipient E comma F. That is action of E comma T and action of E comma F. This is the shown in figure. The representation of the clause in action above clause in action semantic net is shown in figure. See the diagram. This is the external semantic net network representation. Okay, clear. Very, very important topic. External semantic network for. Here, what is semantic net? Here, what is? In knowledge representation logic and semantic networks are two different formalisms are used. Okay. Simple semantic networks are represented as directed graph. Simple semantic networks are represented as directed graph. Okay. These nodes are represented as concepts or objects, and also arcs represents as relationship between concepts or objects. Here, for example, human. Here, collection of variable free assertions are known as variable free assertions. What are the variable free assertion? Collection of variable assertion. Collection of free assertions are called. Are known as variable free assertion. Here, for example, Raju gives an apple. Raju.
Raju is a human, okay? Correct. And Ravi is a human, okay? Easy. Here, E. E to apple. You. Apple. This is the object. Action. Resting driver, who is resting? Ravi. Ravi resting. And actor, Raju. Okay. This is the semantic net diagram. Semantic net. Here, Raju gives an apple to Ravi. Here, Raju gives an apple to Ravi. And Raju and Ravi are human, can be denoted in the semantic network. Okay. Here E is the E means here event. E is event. That is act of giving. Okay. Act of giving. Here Raju is actor. Act equal to Raju. Object equal to apple. Recipient equal to Ravi. Recipient equal to Ravi. Object equal to apple. Here semantic nets can also be have semantic information about situation. About situation. Semantic nets can also be have semantic information about situation. So that actor of event giving is Raju and object is apple. Okay. In that sentence, Raju gives an apple to Ravi. Raju gives an apple to Ravi. The network relationships are causal form is denoted as object of E comma apple. Here E is event. Apple is object is apple. Okay. That means object of E comma apple. Here action equal to give. Okay. Action of E comma give. Actor Raju. So actor of E comma Raju. Actor of E comma Raju. Recipient. Here recipient. Recipient Ravi. Recipient of E comma Ravi. Here Raju is a human, okay? Easy of Raju comma human. Easy of Raju comma human. Here Ravi is a human. That means easy of Ravi comma human. Easy of Ravi comma human.
Geometric model, probabilistic model,
probabilistic
model.
Okay. Here the predicate relations are belongs to the labels and the acts of semantic network always have two arguments. The semantic net can be denotes as binary representation. There is two argument representation. The advantage of that representation is when additional information is added to the given system. For example, the sentence Raju gave an apple to Ravi in the kitchen. It is easy to add location e comma kitchen to the set of facts. Set of facts, okay? In the first order predicate logic, first one, in the first order predicate logic, the predicate relation can have n arguments, okay? Here, where n greater than or equal to 1, okay? For example, next example, the sentence Raju gives an apple to Ravi, okay? Raju gives an apple to Ravi. It is easily denoted in predicate logic. It is easily denoted in predicate logic. As give up Raju, Ravi, apple, clear? Give up Raju, Ravi, apple. Here Raju, Ravi, apple are arguments, okay? Here give is predicate relation. Raju, Ravi. Here, the sentence Raju gives an apple to Ravi. Raju gives an apple to Ravi. It is easily denoted in the predicate logic as give up Raju, comma Ravi, comma apple. Here Raju, Ravi and apple are arguments giving a predicate relation. Arguments. This is predicate relation. Give me. Predicate relation. In predicate logic, representation has greater advantages compared to semantic net representation. As it can be expressed general propositions in addition to simple assertion. And third example. Example 3. In predicate logic, the sentence of Raju gives an apple to everyone. To everyone. This means give up Raju gives an apple. Raju. Raju gives an apple. Here, Ivan, Raju, X, Apple, Arrow, likes up Raju, X. That is give up Raju X comma Apple. Apple. Simply likes up Raju comma X. Here, where X is equal to individual variable. Okay, this in this case X is in our X is equal to individual variable, array is equal to logic connector. Okay. Implied by symbol equal to conclusion of S and right side equal to condition of S. Okay. Here in all advantages, the N array representation of predicate logic is not better to add new information. For example, we have three array relationship. Give up Raju, Ravi, Apple. Denotes as Raju gives an apple to Ravi, and to capture an additional information about kitchen sentence, Raju gives an apple to Ravi in the kitchen. We have to replace the three-ray representation, give up Raju, Ravi, Apple, with a new four-array representation, so that give up Raju, Ravi, Apple, kitchen. Okay. The logic class can be have more conditions. All conditions are must be true, and have more several alternative conclusions. In that, at least one must be true. For example, the sentence: if Raju gives something he likes to a person, then he also likes that person. Likes up Raju X. Give up Raju X Y. Likes up Raju Y. Okay. Raju gives something he likes to a person, then he also likes that person. Here, the conventional semantic network, the conventional semantic network cannot describe the causal logic form. So that to overcome this problem, R. Kowalski was developed extended semantic network in the era of 1979. The extended semantic network combines both logic and semantic network advantages. Okay. The extended semantic network combines both logic and semantic network advantages. The extended semantic network can be interpreted as variant syntax for the causal form of logic and also same expressive power as that predicate logic with well-defined semantics, inference rules, and a procedural interpretation. And also extended networks are incorporates the advantage of using binary relation as in semantic network through an array relation of logic. The extended semantic network very powerful representation is very powerful representation as compared to logic and semantic network. In extended semantic network, the terms are denoted by nodes similar to conventional semantic network. The extended semantic networks are represented as three terms. They are constant, variable, functional terms. In causal logic, binary predicate symbols are represented by labels as extended semantic network of arcs. An action of the form of, okay, so very good. And next, conclusions and conditions. In the extended semantic network, conclusions and conditions of causal form are represented in two different kinds of arcs. They are Daniel links and exceptional links. Daniel links and exceptional links. Okay. 46, 39, 65, late. Daniel links and assertion links. But the Daniel links, the links, the arcs are represented as conditions. Negative atoms are drawn with dotted arrow lines. These are called as Daniel links, dotted arrow lines. Anyway, essentially, the arcs are represented as conclusions, that is positive terms, are drawn with continuous arrow line. These are called as essentially. Here example last section, John her love of John, comma Mary. Okay. That means John loves Mary. Next example, the clausal representation or rule, grandfather of A comma B, that implies father of A comma C, parent of C comma B. Okay, for X Y Z, kada grandfather of X Y, that implies father of X comma Z, parent of Z comma Y. For grandfather in logic can be represented. Okay, here X comma Y are variables. Grandfather of X comma Y equal to consequent of, that means conclusion. Father of X comma Z and parent of Z comma Y, that equal to condition and is there. Okay. And inference rules, this is extended already. The representation of inference for every action of giving, there is an action of taking in causal logic, clausal logic, is action of f of x take, that implies action of x comma give. The interpretation of this rule is the event of taking action is a function of the event of giving action. In the external semantic network representation, functional terms such as f of x are represented by single node. The representation of the statement action of f of x comma take, that implies the action of x comma give, as shown in figure. Okay. Action of f of x comma take, action of x comma give. Okay, clear? Okay. The inference rule that an actor who performs a taking action is also the recipient of this action and can be easily represented in clausal logic. External semantic net as given below. Here is a variable represented as an event of an action of taking. Recipient of E comma X, that implies the action of E comma take, actor of E comma X. Okay. Yeah. Action of E comma take and actor of E comma X. Okay. Recipient of E comma X, that implies actor of E comma X, action of E comma T. Okay. Actor of E comma X and action of actor action is the extended semantic network representation example. Inference rule too, very very important. Today that is very very important. Very 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 important. Very 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 important. extended semantic network representation for KR very important. Fourth unit, very important question. Extended semantic network representation for knowledge representation. Okay. Extended semantic network representation for knowledge. Extended semantic network for knowledge representation. ESNet, that means extended semantic network for knowledge representation. Okay. The deduction of extended semantic networks can be interpreted as two techniques: forward reasoning inference mechanism, backward reasoning inference mechanism. That is bottom up approach and top down approach. Okay, deduction in extended semantic networks can be interpreted as forward reasoning inference mechanism, backward reasoning inference mechanism. That means bottom up approach, top down approach. Bottom up approach, that is, this is an example of forward reasoning inference mechanism. Clear forward reasoning inference mechanism. Second one, backward reasoning inference mechanism. Very important topic. Extended semantic network for knowledge represent, that means KR. Extended semantic network for KR. Very important question. Very important question. This is example reduction of extended semantic network. Okay. Okay, extended semantic network for Very important question. Fourth unit.
Ninth. Last class we discussed about very important. Very after knowledge representation using semantic network, very important. Approaches to knowledge representation, very important question. Approaches to knowledge representation. Knowledge representation using semantic network. Okay. What is the important question? Approaches to knowledge representation. Knowledge representation using semantic network. Extended semantic networks. Five. Knowledge representation. Okay, clear? Thank you.